Hello, Copic fans. Michelle Houghton here. I've got an adorable step from Flora and Fauna this week. So I'm continuing on my holiday theme going here. This time, Flora and Fauna is the feature, and these are our holiday llamas. And I love them. They just had to go into my shopping basket because, you know, yeah, they're just that cute. So I've stamped up two sets of the images. I've got the one guy with his ugly sweater on, or adorable llama sweater. And the other two with their Christmas tree. I'm going to go ahead and color this one up today with his sweater and our two cacti, just because I love the cacti as well, and I think it's pretty fun. We've got some small details here, so some of those I'm just going to fill in versus trying to do a lot of shading. So I'm going to start with my llama. And I've got an E70, and I'm just doing these very short little curls or squiggles on his kind of furry parts, the parts that are woolly, and then kind of smooth coloring over his entire face. Doing a little bit of darker curls again, little swirls with that E71. And really, I'm just doing a little scribble, and then a little bit of that E71 on the sides of his face and his feet. I come back in with a colorless blender on his face to lighten it up, and then decide he needs a little bit of pink. So I've got E93 on his nose and his cheeks. Soften that with E70. I'm gonna go back and forth here a lot. Colorless blender, lighten that back up, and then decide he needs still a little more pink. E93, E70, and then I feel like he's okay. So, moving on to the cacti, I've got a YG41. I'm just experimenting a little bit with my YGs today, so if you don't have these particular ones, no worries. The YG45 is going to do the spines, or those long vertical stripes on the sequoia. Those guys have these very long vertical stripes to them, so I'm doing that in a long flicking motion from the top and bottom. And then YG93 is going to kind of accentuate that and add that deeper tone because it's desaturated. Remember that 9 at the start of that number is going to mean it's got some gray in it. YG23 is going to base my other guy over here to the right. And I'm filling in all those paddles with that YG23. And then I'm coming back with YG25. These all, even though they're flat, have kind of an oval shape to them. So I'm giving a little bit of sense of how they come in, back in at the base, in where they attach into the paddle below, and kind of give that sense a little bit of that form. YG95 again is going to add even that deeper shading. I feel like adding something with that higher desaturation number, that saturation number, is going to help create that shape. Then down to the terracotta pots, I'm kind of sticking with the desert theme that the cactus have suggested, or cacti. I've got E93 and then I've got E99, and that's a big jump in number, but I know that these two colors work pretty well together, and it's going to give me that warm peachy glow of that terracotta pottery. So back to E93 to smooth that out, and then I feel like I push it a little too far. The highlight area goes too far, so I come back with my E99 just a little bit, and then back one last time with the E93, and I just don't push it quite as far this time. It just softens it up. Y21 just barely touches that star to fill it in, and then I've got two colors that are going to go in on his sweater. So I'm thinking holiday, keeping it very traditional. I've got a R24, and that's going to hit some of those stripes and just some of those small details. I am not going to do any shading on this. It truly is just about filling this in, giving him some color. And then I'm also going to add some YG03, and that's kind of just that kind of bold, bright green color for the contrast. And then I debate back and forth, do I want the stripes on the legs? No. Yes. No, yes, fill one in. I do this a lot. If I haven't practiced the image one time and I just film it for the first time, you see all of these debates in my head of, do I color this or not? So E50 is going to go for the ground. So I'm going to say this little guy is standing outside. Llamas would be more suited outside, and he's standing amidst his decorated cacti. So this is kind of a desert dusty or dirt ground. So the E50 is my base, and then I use an E31, and I'm going to add just some cast shadows underneath the cacti and the llama. Notice I'm hinting at the shape of the cacti, and then I'm roughing up the ground around because I don't think it's totally smooth. So just adding some texture to that ground. E33 is coming in right at the base of each of those shadows to get darker as it comes in toward the object where it connects to the object that it's casting a shadow from. Soften that with the E31, soften again, E50, and that softens the entire ground. I did speed this whole section with the ground part up a little further. You might have noticed that, but I feel like some of these bigger areas, and then the sky is so big, again, you don't necessarily need to see me fill this in. I'm using small circles. I get a little slower as I approach like the cacti itself and the llama, but I'm just doing at least 2 to 3 coats, minimum 2 to 3 coats on this whole, all of these areas. And that's gonna give me that nice smooth color. I'm leaving the edge, like out toward the edge of that rectangle, the border, I'm leaving that loose, and I will come back and actually leave probably a white border around that. I've ended up doing that on a lot of my cards recently, and I just like the look. So it may not be perfectly square, but I'm okay with that. So BG000, squaring that up a bit. And then I decide, because of the way the stamp works, it ends up with these black spots kind of where the ornaments or lights are on the cacti. And we've got some little details. So I bring some stickles in and I go ahead and decorate my cacti, and I decorate, so the star at the top on the left, and then each of these little ornaments hanging from the cacti at the right. And then I decide to give the string of dots, turn those into more like Christmas lights, and over on the sequoia or the cacti on the left. So I'm going to use red and green and just alternate that. Some of this I have a stick pin handy, and a lot of times when I'm using stickles like this, I have to stop for a second and stick that stick pin down the nose of the bottle just to get it going again. So we've got red and green details, a little red on the earmuffs so those aren't plain black, and I debated on the sweater, but I decided to go with more of a clear, and the one I had in my hand actually didn't work at all. I could never get it going. I had to run get another, but I add some sparkle on those snowflakes on his sweater. And just clear, instead of adding a color and losing the snowflake little idea. So I'm just adding some clear sparkles on top of each of those snowflakes to kind of finish off his festive sweater. Thank you so much for joining me this week as we get closer and closer to the Christmas holiday or winter holidays. I hope you and your family are doing well. I always appreciate you stopping by. If you haven't had a chance, please like this YouTube channel so you can see all of our comings and goings, or my comings and goings these days, and get a new little tutorial in your inbox every week. If you have a chance, stop by my blog as well, because classes for 2019 are just starting to open up. Thank you so much for stopping by. Have a happy, colorful week.